Evening, friends, my YouTube friend. Thanks for joining here at the 740 Weather Channel. Things are changing and more people have watches and warnings up now. I'll get into all of that from the National Hurricane Center in just a moment. Over here is disturbance number one. You can see it is hitting land. It still never got really organized. This is another tropical wave. That's where you guys down in the island areas are getting rain from right now. This is Beryl. Beryl is still a tropical storm, but let me tell you what. Before it hits the islands, it will be a major hurricane. Now, for those of you who've met me throughout the hurricane season and the early part of the season, I told you guys on my, you might have a hurricane this year. Now, this might not be the worst major hurricane. We'll have to wait and see. I don't think it'll get but so high, but I do think it will have sustained of 115 miles per hour. Wind gust much higher. It looks going to be a windstorm instead of yet to and zoom in power. Well, because there's not any wind shear out here. Once it gets over here, the wind shear will change from what it looked like earlier in the week. It looked like it would ramp up in intensity. It's still going to be a hurricane, but it won't be a major hurricane because there'll be more wind shear up here. Wind shear's what you see around this is a little bit of dry dust, but believe it or not, it is helping it to form, okay? And you can see it has the circular motion, and it is very well organized now. Just a few showers are disorganized in it. Over here, this coming off the coast of Africa, disturbance number two. Folks, I hate to tell all the island areas, this thing's going to form and ramp up too. And it should be there probably sometime next weekend. So, right now, Beryl has sustained winds of 63 miles per hour with wind gust hurricane force 75 miles per hour, and the pressure is 29.47 according to my calculations. Now let's go over and check out the National Hurricane Center. Okay, let's get going here right quick. We have disturbance number one. This is going to be more rain than wind, folks. The Northwestern Caribbean and Southwestern Gulf of Mexico, AL Invest 94. It's a broad area of low pressure still. Looks like it may form a little bit over the Bay of Campeche tonight or early tomorrow, where conditions appear generally conducive for further development. A tropical depression could form. I think it will be a tropical depression that will form before the system moves inland again early next week over Mexico. Interest along the Gulf Coast of Mexico should monitor the progress of the system regardless of development. Heavy rainfall associated with this area of low pressure will affect portions of Central America and Mexico through early next week. This is going to be a rainmaker, not a windmaker. Sure, you'll have a little few gusts blow up now and then, but rain is what's headed your way, 50% 2 days and 7 days. Then over here, this is disturbance number two. It's an area of low pressure. You can see it on the map. It's several hundred miles southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. It's producing an area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms. Now, looking like environmental conditions appear conducive for additional development of this system. A tropical depression could form by the middle of next week, and it's moving westward 15 to 20 miles per hour across the eastern and central tropic Atlantic. Now, in 2 days, it's going to stay fairly quiet at 30% chance of forming. But by the end of the week, look at there, moved up to 70%. And it looks like it may get even higher at this point in time. Remember, things can change. But if it doesn't change, you see where the cone goes. Very same hour areas for the islands, maybe even a little lower. Please stay safe and be aware. Okay, folks, listen up and listen good for the latest information. Beryl is expected to become a dangerous major hurricane before reaching the Windward Islands. It's located with the coordinates at 10.0 north, 48.4 west. It's about 785 miles east-southeast of Barbados. The sustained winds are 65 miles per hour. and they were 63 when I checked them, and the gust was 75, so it's probably 78. It already has hurricane strength gust, and all of this is going to intensify. So please be aware of it and stay safe, okay? The government of Dominica has issued a tropical storm watch for these areas. Martinique, Dominique, and Tobago, you're under a tropical storm watch. A hurricane watch is in effect for Barbados, St. Lucia, St. Vincent, and the Grenadine Islands and Grenada. I told you guys all up and down this chain in my earlier videos this week, be ready. It's going to jog around. Once again, hurricane watch in effect for Barbados, St. Lucia, St. Vincent, and the Grenadine Islands and Grenada. Tropical storm watch in effect for Martinique, Dominique, and Tobago. And interests elsewhere in the Lesser Antilles should closely monitor the progress of Beryl. Additional watches and warnings will likely be required for portions of this area later this afternoon. Now, I'm going to hop down just a minute. Excuse me. Storm surge, 5 to 7 feet above normal. 5 to 7 feet above normal. Rainfall, 3 to 6 inches across parts of Barbados, the Windward Islands, Sunday night into Monday. And it could cause some flooding. So, you know, you're going to have rip currents and all this stuff and heavy surf and flooding. Don't go in the water, okay? But like I said earlier, this is going to be a windstorm. Watches and warnings from the National Hurricane Center. Right now, it's still a tropical storm. But honey, in a few minutes, I'd say before nightfall, it's going to be a hurricane, okay? Then moving right along, you can see by the time it reaches the island areas, you're under a hurricane watch right now, all of these little islands right in here, but you're going to be under a hurricane warning before it's over because it's going to be a major hurricane. Not a one or a two. It's going to be at least a three, and let's pray it don't get to a four. It's going to stay that way until Tuesday when it's south of Puerto Rico. And then we got some more sheer wind out here. That's what's going to help Jamaica and portions of the Dominican Republic out in this area. It will return to a Category 1 or 2 status by Wednesday through Thursday as it passes this through this area here. Now, you can see the yellow is tropical storm watches and warnings. The pink is hurricane watches. Please click the description box below this video and I'll have some of this stuff posted. The important information that you need to know, okay? Right now, the key message is Beryl is expected to rapidly strengthen and be a major hurricane when it reaches the Windward Islands late Sunday night or Monday, bringing destructive hurricane force winds and life-threatening storm surge. A hurricane watch is in effect for much of the Windward Islands. Heavy rainfall and localized flooding is expected across the Windward Islands Sunday night and Monday. Interest in the Central and Western Caribbean should monitor the progress of this system. Now, users are reminded that there is a large uncertainty at days 4 and 5 and not to focus on the specific details of the track and the intensity force. And I've told you this, and that's why I'm telling Jamaica to get right, because you could get some hurricane stuff. Also, the Dominican Republic. I don't think the way it looks now, Puerto Rico will get a bad deal out of this, but that could change. So, especially if you're in the southern sections of Puerto Rico, just make sure you got your kits together in case you need them. And you can see the intensity forecast in 24 hours. The sustained winds will be 100 miles per hour. And by the time it gets to you, the sustained winds will be 110 miles per hour to 115 miles per hour with wind gust of 120 to 125. So I'm leaving you with this information. Be ready, my friends. Stay safe no matter what. Check on the elderly. Check on your neighbors. Check on the handicapped. Help each other out. Make sure you've got everything together and a way to stay in contact with your family and friends. Please keep me posted what's going on in your areas when this stuff starts. I love you guys. I thank you for every single thing you do for me. And may you all be blessed and stay safe. Don't forget to share this. I'd appreciate it to help me keep people safe and aware of what's coming their way. And you try to have yourself a good evening, a safe evening, and a blessed evening. Thanks for watching.